doesn't show up in the temple to Paul, but actually they are passing through this massive stone shaped like an arm. And every time I read the word of God, I remember that priest. And I look at it in a spiritual way. You know? And if you listen, God said, Moses, strike the rock, and sweet water will come out of that rock. That rock is Jesus. Amen? And if, listen, if you don't want to do what God says, you're certainly going to be hurt in the long run. If we don't go through there, we are out in the open ocean. Where is God? We must go through there. You just must. You must obey the word of God. Amen. Don't follow what everybody's saying. You can't do as you like and live like how you like. Live like a dog. Live like a cat. And then you're ready. Whenever you come to the door of death, you open that door, you're in heaven. No. You're not in heaven. Amen. You just can't go to heaven like that. But God is counting on us who are Christians to let people know the truth. Look at John 4:35. We need to give them the truth. Say not ye, ye are your poor, and then come and harvest. Behold, I say unto you, lift up your eyes and look on the field, for they are white already to harvest. We got to look out. Look out in the streets. Yes. The people are ready. It's going to be harvest time anytime. Yes. And we are his workers. God is counting on us. How many people, since the year began, we have emphasized soul winning as much as possible can? How many of you have given us a chance since then? How many of you have tried? Raise your hand and see. Let me see now. You'll tell me how to preach. You'll give me a shot. Amen. How many of you have gone out with the church team so willing at least one, just one time? Amen. Amen. How many of you have been praying for the souls of people? What about the family? The Bible tells us that he first findeth his own brother. Amen? The hardest person to reach is the blood force. The kinfolk. The wife, the husband, the children, the auntie, and all of those people. It's hard to reach them. Very hard. That's very difficult. I don't know what to tell you how to reach them. Other than, I can tell you like husband and wife. I can tell you, show love. Love the wife, love the husband. I can tell you that. You can show love. You know, some wives like to, some simple little frivolous thing that should. You should show love to them, but they don't show. You know that? You will see his parents need to take out the priest. But they won't take out the priest. And then they'll say, oh, look at the parents' priest up. Hey man, you sit up, man. Take it out. That's loud. Take out the priest. The idea was coming to church and I just take the pants just out of the hand how it was and it part in two. And I said, I'm going to put this on. And I put it on and here comes the lady. Yes, sir. The crease on the pants. I said, everybody will see. And now that they don't know where it was, they know it was on a hammer. But she got outside with the shoes inside. She was saying amen. If you are taking out crease out of your clothes, why you didn't take out of my clothes? I'm not begging for the love. I'm not begging for love that I'm over 50 years, right? But I'm only saying, through experience, there's a lot of men who look at that, and they see that little love. Now suppose the man is a Christian. If the man, she is the Christian, and the man is not the Christian. He is looking at that. She's supposed to show me some little love. One pan, one pan, one pan, one. Yeah, a little, yeah, a little. That's what the Bible says, right? That's how doctrine is built. The doctrine of love is built that way. One upon one, yeah, a little, yeah, a little. So it's built. Simple little things that we don't think that is important. It's important, right? It's important. Amen? It's important. So, show the love. That's the only thing I can, you know, I can tell you how to reach the blood folks, the close folks to you. Show love to your children if you are a Christian and you want to see them get saved. Show love to your brother or your sister. You want to see them get saved without them and saved. Amen. Show love. I always remember to talk about this young man that we saw in pastor school. And he lived 950 miles from pastor school. And we chose the night Dr. Curtis Watson was preaching and reaching the loved ones. And after the message, he was so touched that he picked up his vehicle and drove 950 miles to meet his father, just to reach his father. Went and tell his father about Jesus. Won him to Christ and drove back so that he was in the service and told him. That's 1900 miles. 950 go and 950 come. Just to tell, to show love to his father. Because the emphasis was on love. To show love. Nobody tell her what I said. Don't tell her. If she ever gets to know that, and I know who tells me, tell me. God needs